Hello everyone, Saurabh here again. So I'm back with the most important and the most exciting thing for me at the moment is the agriculture reforms that have been undertaken by the Indian government. And there are many other reforms in this five tranches. Out of that, the first I have already explained in detail. And subsequently, the other you can just go through the particular prints by our Indian government on the social media handles, and they are all self-explanatory. So I didn't thought of actually that they need some sort of explanation. But yeah, agriculture reforms. I wanted all my viewers as well as my colleagues to understand and analyze that what exactly they are, because they are the one that you can compare with the 1991 economic reforms that was for freeing up the business. And here, our Indian government has taken steps for freeing up the agriculture. What is India? What any of the people across the world think when they, you know, hear the name India? First thing that comes to their mind is the agriculture. India is an agriculture land, a rich land. So the, you know, the basis of India is agriculture. So till the agriculture don't generate that sort of revenues, okay, you won't be able to, you know, revive an economy. And thinking about a global leader, a long-term plan, then agriculture is a particular sector that can generate a sort of revenue that the Indian government is currently thinking. And I appreciate it that this particular reforms have been undertaken. There were about few years down the line, late Arun Jaitley had told some discussion with the finance experts that what other sector other than GST that the government considers for giving the boost in the revenues. So Arun Jaitley was straight away said that it is the agriculture sector. And the reforms in agriculture sector are the ones that were going into the Indian government mind still, since many years. Especially in Modi 1 and now in Modi 2. So, this COVID-19 crisis, you can say, has given an opportunity for Indian government to, you know, implement that measures. Okay, and I hope these measures get practical as soon as possible without any footnotes in between what I have seen in the print and the social media. Now, here comes my analysis. You understand it very properly, because this is what, a financial sector, what you can say, a learner or a person like me wants for reviving an economy. In 1991, okay, it was a corporate reforms, okay, but they didn't, had any sort of, plans for reviving the agriculture sector. Okay, they were looking more after the investment and liberalizing the business. Here, the government has undertaken three important steps. There are other 8 steps also, but the last 3 steps that has been, that is really exciting for me. So the number one is the step that is essential commodity acts will be eradicated. Okay, there will be some very important amendments in it. APMC Act and contract farming. Now the government has not used the term contract farming, but it's like the government's indirectly said that the contract farming will be the one that will, you know, help the farmers to, you know, generate the revenues and, you know, improve their livelihood. So I will come for the first point, that is the Essential Commodity Act. Okay. So what exactly is the Essential Commodity Act? So in this point I will cover the first two, that is APMC and the ECA. The APMC market, you can say Azad Nagar of New Delhi, or if you are in Mumbai, you can say the Vashi market of Mumbai. APMC market has the control over the pricing of the essential commodities okay, as well as they can manipulate the price accordingly if they are involved into some unethical practices. Okay, so now after the eradication of this Essential Commodity Act or amendments in it, what will happen? Okay, now I will take an example. For example, onion price is rupees 40. Suddenly it has, you know, the price has rise to about 80 rupees. Okay, and APMC has a control, they have the control over the storage facility, the storage of these essential commodities. They have the power to control the trader and ask them that they cannot store up to 50 quintals of so-and-so, particular commodity. So if the price of onion have rise from 40 rupees to 80 rupees, okay, and if that particular trader has not that sort of storage, automatically that is going to create the shortage of that commodity and the price will boost further. Okay, so are you understanding it? So here the trader and the farmers, they are the one actually who will face the difficulty. So the monopolistic attitude of this marketing, this market communities, the APMC, they have, that will be now streamlined and to the some extent I can say will be eradicated, because there will be now the private houses that will start storage of this essential commodities as well. Okay, so this price manipulation or the unethical practices will be totally stopped. Okay. On the other hand, whenever a farmer has to sell something, he will go to the APMC and he is going to sell over there, or he will actually give it to a middleman and he will go to APMC and sell over there. So there are various middlemen who are going to, from a farmer to a particular consumer, there including APMC, there are various middlemen in between where there are pay points where the leakage of pricing happens. So for example, a farmer has to be given rupees 12 for that particular commodity per kg I'm talking about. So eventually that farmer will earn just rupees 6, because rest 6 rupees will get distributed in this agents, including the APMC. So the farmer is getting 50% less of it. What government has done? The government has opened alternate sale points for the farmers. So there will be mechanism, okay, or in line with the milk revolution that happened, where there were milk cooperative societies where the particular milk producer are going and selling their milk and getting appropriate price. So there will be agriculture cooperative societies where the farmer will go and they will get a particular price that has been mentioned by the government. So milk revolution didn't happen in a day. It took years. The government are taking the steps now, and that will be fruitful in coming years. In line with the milk revolution, this will be essential commodity revolution and agriculture revolution. So you can understand how important this is. E-trading portal will also be started where the farmers can directly sell to the consumers, and the government will help them to do it. Can you imagine how, game changer, this is a game changer if you consider the long-term scenario. We are not in 1943 or 1955 where the mass starvation took place. There is production and there are many areas that do bulk production. but they don't have that sort of storage capacity where they can store. Because the APMC have, you know, they have the power to manipulate the storage as well. So now this reforms will give the private sector to, you know, generate the storage warehouses. Okay, plus they will give an opportunity for farmers to sell their product in the agriculture market, you know, cooperative societies. And additionally, the farmer will get alternate sale points and they can e-trade their vegetables as well. So the mandi fee says everything can be shared, and basically the farmers will be benefited as well as the end user, that is us. Are you understanding? So do what you have done for milk, do the same for the vegetables. That's the motto of this agriculture reforms. Break the nexus between the inefficient and the corrupt that are hurting the farmers' revenue. And subsequently, there are many cases that the farmers are doing suicide. I am a buyer, I can buy from anywhere. I am a seller, I can sell it anywhere. I have the freedom to do that. And that's the agriculture reforms for you. Are you understanding? So the jurisdiction of the courtyard of market, and subsequently one country, one ration card, one license can buy anywhere. These all are the plans of the Indian government. They are all long-term plans. Okay, so we need to have that sort of patience. And we need to give some time for our Indian government. And we all together, you know, can help our Indian government and help each of ourselves. Just, you know, give us some time. Okay, and everything will improve. Because these particular steps are going to be very, 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 you know, beneficial for our especially Indian economy. MSME is obviously there, but agriculture has the huge potential. MSME has huge potential for generating employment. Agriculture has huge potential for generating the revenue. And the last point that indirectly the finance minister has said, has specified, that is the contract farming. So not going into you know, the theoretical language, I will tell you in a very simple language what exactly it is. I am a private company. Okay, I am going to the farmer straight away. Okay, I have asked them to give me 5,000 quintals of a particular commodity. Okay, the rate in the market that is going up is rupees 10, which the farmer is, you know, after going through all this middlemen, they are getting only 5 to 6 rupees. So they are at a loss of 4 to 5 rupees accordingly. The private company goes directly to the farmer and they ask that you produce the 5,000 quintal of that respective commodity. Okay, I will give you 15 rupees. Obviously, that's a great deal for farmer. They will accept it. They will make, you know, they will produce that 5,000 quintals. The private company will take it. And the private organization who will be taking, you know, part in this contract farming, they will already have their supply chain streamlined. So they will be able to sell this particular, you know, commodity at rupees 22 or 23 or 20. Still they are earning about 5, 6, 7 rupees per kg. So everyone is benefiting over. There is no shortage of the commodity. Okay, the farmers are getting, you know, directly from 6 rupees, rupees 15 rupees, so 9 rupees directly they are getting access in their hands. Plus, you know, the private companies are getting their share. They are also generating the employment opportunity accordingly. Also, they are earning the profit. They will be paying the GST and this is again a revenue for the government. And the end consumer, who will be happy that the rate is not varying. So these are the three important aspects of the economic reforms that I would rate on par with the 1991 corporate or business freeing up reforms. Okay, so please take a note of it again. Number one, eradication of Essential Commodity Act. Number two, APMC Act, amendments in it. And number three is the contract farming. Thank you very much, all of you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.